In this video, we're going to go over the basics of quantum circuits. And so we're going to look into the very basics of qubit state representations. We're going to learn about qubit gates. This is what we call the operators in qubit quantum circuits. Then we're going to look into a very simple quantum circuit with just one qubit. And then we're going to look into two qubit circuits and how it would move on to like n qubit circuits. So let's get started. So what are qubits and what are state representations? And so in this context of circuits, we're looking at qubits usually as these basic states. So a qubit can, for example, have the state 0 or 1. And in general, any quantum state based on these two basis states is the superposition of these amplitudes of these basic states. So we call this the actual state, the psi here, this in this bracket notation, and these are the amplitudes of these basic states. And how to interpret these amplitudes, it all follows down into probabilities of measuring a state. We'll take care of that in a later video. Today, we're just going to look at this basic representation. Now, let's look at the very basic operations on single qubit. The first one is the X gate, also called the NOT gate. And that's very similar to what you're used to when you think about just normal computer logic circuits. So the NOT gate applied to the zero state will turn the state into a one state, and the NOT gate applied to a one state will turn it into a zero state. Very simple. That's one of the gates we're going to be using. And the other one in this video is going to be the Z gate, also called the phase flip gate. And so what does the Z gate do? Well, if the Z operates on a zero qubit state, nothing actually happens. There's not going to be any change. But if it finds a one state, it will change the sign. So here it will add the negative sign to the state. So that's the phase flip gate. And you can see it's conditional on what the actual state is. Now let's look into a very simple qubit circuit. And the way they're represented is usually this line. So you can kind of read this left to right. The state goes in and comes out as a different state. And here it will go through the X operator, the X gate, and the Z gate. So let's see, if we enter a zero state into this circuit, now the X gate will turn that into a one state. And now we go through the Z phase split operator, and because it is the one state, we're now changing the sign. Let's do another example. Let's start with the one state going through the X, becomes zero. Now we're going through the phase shift, but because it is the zero state, nothing actually changes and we'll end up with the zero state. Now let's put this a little bit more generic. If we put in a quantum state psi, we run it through this circuit, and what comes out is psi, psi notated here, so a slightly different state. And let's see, so psi is represented as the basis states and their amplitudes. So we're going to apply these operators on these two states. Let's see what happens. So we're applying the X state, and of course, the zero becomes the one state becomes the zero state. Afterwards, this full state goes through the Z gate, and what happens is we change the sign of the one state, but we do not change it of the zero state. And now this is our new state representation. This is the state, how it changed after going through this single one qubit circuit. Now let's look at the next more complex step. So we have circuits with two qubits. These would be two lines, and we are identifying them. So the lowest line we'd always call the zeroth qubit, and then the next higher line, the first qubit. And if we brought this to n number of qubits, we would have just, you know, n number of lines on top of one another. And now, because we have two qubits, each of them can have two basis states, 0 and 1, our basis states are now 4, 2 by 2. So we have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And the convention we're going to be following is that the 0th qubit is the rightmost qubit. And then the next qubit, the first qubit, is left of that. And if we had n number of qubits, they would all be added to the left and all fit into this bracket. So we have this type of notation. And that's what we have to keep in mind if we now propagate these states through our two qubit circuits. So let's take a simple two qubit circuit. An x operator on the first qubit, then a zero operator on the 0th qubit, and then a z operator on the first qubit again. So let's see, if we add, bring in the state 0, 0 here, we run this state through the x operator, it will flip the first qubit. And remember, this is the leftmost one in this convention. Now we're running it through the z operator, because the 0th qubit is 0, nothing actually changes, there is no phase flip. But now as we go to this z operator, this will see the 1 here, and it will change the sign of that state. So this is the outcome of putting the 0, 0 state through this quantum circuit. Let's do one more. We start with the 1, 0 state through the x operator, acting on the first qubit, it will make it into a 0. And now we run the z operator, but both of these qubit states are 0, so there's not going to be any phase shift or sign change. And now, if we actually look into a full quantum state in this two qubit circuit, we know that the quantum state is again broken down to its basis states and the respective amplitudes. So we added to alpha and beta, we have added gamma and delta. And now as we run this through this circuit, we have to operate it on all of these four states. So the first step is going through this x state, and you see it will change the first qubit. So 0 becomes to 1, 0 becomes to 1, 1 becomes 0, 1 becomes 0. Now we're going to the z operator. And remember, so the 0th qubit, if 0th qubit is 1, then we do a sign change. Now here the 0th qubit is 0, no sign change. Here the 0th qubit is 1, we do have a sign change. Nothing happens here, it's all 0. And on this state, the 0th qubit is 1, so we have the sign change. And we do that one more time with this z operator acting on the first qubit. So here, first qubit is 1, sign change. First qubit is 1, we bring in another minus, and remember, negative and negative makes plus, so this becomes plus now again. Again, nothing changes on the 0, 0 qubit state. And then this here, also nothing changes because this qubit state is 0. Okay, and with that, we're at the end of the video. This is a nice intro for, you know, qubit circuits. We went through basic operations, the x operator, the z operator, also called gates. We've looked into qubit circuits. We took it all the way to two qubit circuits. I hope this provided you with a nice overview of what this is all about. I plan to do more videos with more complex operations, more complex circuits, and also a little bit more background on why we do that. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.